वेलकम स्टूडेंट, माई नेम इज़ कुलदीप सिंह सोलंकी। टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक इज आवर टॉपिक इज सम एग्जाम्पल ऑफ इंडिटर्मिनेसी बोथ ऑफ स्टैटिक एंड काइनेमेटिक्स। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द सम एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ स्टैटिक इंडिटर्मिनेसी एंड काइनेमेटिक इंडिटर्मिनेसी। सो एनी स्टूडेंट न्यू हेयर प्लीज गो द प्रीवियस वीडियो एंड सी दैट एंड आफ्टर दैट कम हेयर। सो नाउ वी स्टार्ट्स। For rigid jointed plane frame, this is some examples of indeterminacy. First example is this is a fixed beam. In this video, in this lecture, we are all example is for rigid jointed and plane frame. Rigid jointed means all the member are connected by rigid jointed, and plane frame it means just for 2D. So see that let's see the first example. This is the fixed beam. In this beam, we calculate the ds and dk both. Ds means static indeterminacy and dk means kinematic indeterminacy. So first we calculate the dk. ds, the formula of ds is the addition of dac and dsi. It means external static indeterminacy plus internal static indeterminacy. So we calculate first dac means external static indeterminacy. The formula is R minus E. What is the R? R is the number of reaction available in our structure. So let's see the structure. This is a fixed beam, two end A and end B. At end A, the support is fixed support. So at that support, three reactions are available. First is horizontal, second is vertical, third is moment. Because we know that at fixed support, three reactions are available. So and next support is also fixed support, B is also fixed support. So three reaction will generate. So in this case, total reaction is six, one horizontal, two vertical and two moment. So the how many reaction? Total reaction is six, three at end A and three at B. And E, what is the E? Is the equilibrium equation. This is the 2D structure. And for 2D structure, rigid joint structure, number of equilibrium equation is 3. So total number of equilibrium equation is 3. So 6 minus 6 is equals to 3. The value of DSE, it means external static indeterminacy, is 3. So now we calculate the internal static indeterminacy. The formula is 3C minus R dash. 3C. C is the number of loops available in our structure, but see our structure, no any loop are available. So the value of C is equals to 0, and R dash is responsible for hinge, totally for hinge. So in our structure, no hinge are available. So value of R dash is equals to 0. Now put the all values in the formula for of DSI. So 3 into 0 minus 0. So we get the values 0 for DSI because no any loop available and no any hinge are available in our structure. So the total DSI is equals to 3 plus 0, it means 3. In this case, this beam is statically indeterminate by 3 degree. So we can say this beam is statically indeterminate by 3rd degree or 3 degree. So also we can calculate the kinematic indeterminacy for this beam. So the formula of kinematic indeterminacy is 3j minus r plus r dash. What is the j? J is the number of joint available in our structure. So see the structure, two joint are available, A and B. Then value of j is equals to 2, and how many reactions? R means how many reactions are available? 6 reaction. And value of r dash, we know already that 0. So put the values in formulas and we can find dk. Dk is equals to 3 into 2 minus 6 plus 0. So 3 into 2 6 minus 6 is equals to 0. Then in this case, the kinematic indeterminacy is equals to 0. So is it clear for first example? So so next example is second example. This is the continuous beam. And we know that the three member are connected and four joints are available, A, B, C and D. At A, this is a fixed support. At fixed support, three reactions are available. First is horizontal, second is vertical, and third is moment. So at A, three reactions are available. At B, this is the pin joint. This is the pin connected. And pin support, at pin support, we know that only two reactions are available, one vertical and one horizontal. At C, this is the roller. We know at roller only one vertical reaction are available. So at D also a roller, so one vertical reaction is available. So we calculate for first DS for this beam. So formula of DS is equals to DSE plus DSI. We can calculate first DSE. So the formula of DS is equals to R minus E. In this case, value of R, how many number of reaction are available? So first add the total reaction, add three reaction at A, two reaction at B, and one reaction at C, and one reaction at D. How many total number of reaction? 3, 2, 1, 1. It means total number of reaction is 7. So value of R is equals to 7. E, what is the E? E is the number of equilibrium equation. This is also rigid structure and 2D. So the number of equilibrium equation is 3. What is the equilibrium equation? Summation of forces in x direction is equals to 0. Summation of forces in y direction is equals to 0. Summation of forces in z, summation of moments in z direction is equals to 0. So three equilibrium equation are available. So put the values in formulas and find the DSE. R minus E, 7 minus 3 is equals to 4. Now we get the value of DS is equals to 4. So also calculate the DSI, internal static indeterminacy. The formula of internal static indeterminacy is 3C minus R dash. It means C means how many loop are available in our structure. So there is no loop for this case. So value of C is equals to 0, and also no hinge are available in our structure. So value of R dash is equals to 0. Now put the values in formula. DSI is equals to 3 into 0 minus 0. So also in this case DSI is equals to 0. So now total static indeterminacy is equals to 4 plus 0. It means 4. Now we can say the our beam, yeah, our structure is statically indeterminate by 4 degree, because we have 4 unknowns. DS, value of DS is equals to 4. So we can say this is indeterminate by 4 degree. Also we can calculate the decay for this structure. The value of decay formulas for 3J minus RE plus R dash. J means how many joints are available in our structure. So see the structure, joint A, joint B, joint C and joint D. It means 4 joints are available. The value of J is equals to 4. How many reaction? 3 reaction at A, 2 reaction at B, 5, and 1 reaction at C, 6 reaction, and 1 reaction at D. It means 7 reaction. Total number of reaction is 7. Then value of R dash, because no hinge are available in our structure, so R dash value is 0. So put the, all the values in formula. So we can get the decay is equals to 3 into 4 minus 7 plus 0. So value of decay is equals to 5. If we are neglecting the axial deformation, the value of decay is 5. But if we are neglecting the axial deformation, so that we can calculate decay dash. What is the decay dash? Decay minus M. M, what is the M? M is the number of axially rigid member. So how many member are axially rigid in our structure? Then one AB member, BC member and CD member. Three member are available. So subtract from decay. Decay dash equals to 5 minus 3, it equals to 2. Then for this case, value of kinematic indeterminacy is 2. If after neglecting axial deformation, if you are not neglecting, then the value of decay is 5. Okay. Now for next example is 3. In third example, phenol, we calculate the ds and dk both for this case. So formula of ds is equals to dsc plus dsi, it means external static indeterminacy and internal static indeterminacy. So first we calculate dsc, then formula of dsc is equals to r minus e. What is the number of reaction are available? So let's see in the figure 8a, this is the fixed support, it means three reaction are available, one vertical, one horizontal and one moment ones, okay. And 8d also, this is a fixed support, three reaction are available. 8c, this is the roller, one reaction are available. And 8e, this is the pin joint or simply supported pin joint, it means two reaction are available. So how many total reaction? 3, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then value of r is equals to 9. For this case, number of equilibrium equation is, this is a rigid jointed and 2D frame. So in this case, number of equilibrium equation is 3. Summation of fx is equals to 0, summation of fy is equals to 0 and summation of moment 0. So 3 equilibrium equation are available. Then subtract from r to equilibrium equation, 9 minus 3 is equals to 6. Then value of ds is equals to 6, and we also we can calculate dsi. Then formula of dsi is equals to 3c minus r dash, and c means how many loops are available. There is no loop in this structure and no any hinge are available in our structure. So value of dsi is equals to 0, and total static indeterminacy is equals to 6 plus 0 is equals to, it means 6. So we can say our structure is indeterminate by statically indeterminate. Our structure is statically indeterminate by 6 degree, okay. Also we can calculate the decay for this structure. The value of formula for decay is 3j minus r plus r days. Then j means how many joints are available. So how many joints? Joint A, joint B, joint C, joint D and joint E. 5 joints are available in our structure. So value of j is equals to 5, and value of reaction, value of r is equals to 9. Total 9 reaction are available and no hinge are available. So value of r base is equals to 0. Then put all the values in our formula. Find the decay, 3 into 5 minus 9 is equals to 0. Value of decay is also 6. If you are neglecting the axial deformation, number of member, subtract number of member from decay. Then how many number of member are available? Member AB, member BC, member CD, 3 member and member BE. It means 4 member are available. So subtract from decay number of member, it means decay minus M, 6 minus 4 is equals to 2. Then value of decay after neglecting axial deformation, 2, and before neglecting axial deformation, the value of dk is equals to 6. So this is clear for example third. So next example is fourth example. This is the beam fixed at A, pin connected at B and roller at C. So in this case, fixed support at A, it means 3 equation are available, 3 reaction are available. First is horizontal reaction, vertical reaction and moments. At B, this is a pin joint, it means 2 reaction are available. And at C, this is the roller, roller have only one reaction, one vertical reaction. So also we can calculate ds and dk for this case. So now calculate ds, value of ds is equals to dsc plus dsi. DSC means external static indeterminacy. The value of r minus e, how many reaction are available? 3, 2 and 1. It means 6 reaction are available. Then how many equilibrium equation for this case? 3. So 6 minus 3 is equals to 3. The value of static external static indeterminacy is 3, and also we can calculate DSI. DSI is the internal static indeterminacy. Formula is 3c minus r dash. Also there is no loop and there is no hinge in this structure. So the value of c is equals to 0 and then value of r dash is equals to 0. Now put the values in formulas and we can get dsi is equals to 0. So the total ds is equals to 3 plus 0, it means 3. Then we can say this beam is statically indeterminate by third degree, okay, because value of ds is equals to 3. So we can say this beam is statically indeterminate by third degree. Also we can calculate the decay for this structure. Value of dk is equals to formula for dk is 3j minus r plus r dash. J means how many joints are available in this structure. The joint A, joint B, joint C, 3 joints are available. And how many reaction are available? Reaction, 3 reaction at A, 2 reaction at B and 1 reaction at C, and total reaction is 6, and there is no hinge, so our value of R dash is equals to 0. Then put the values in formula and we can get dk by this formula, and value of dk is 3. It means its kinematic indeterminacy is 3. If we are neglecting the axial deformation, then number of member is subtracting from dk. So how many member are available? 2 member are available, AB member and BC member. So subtract 2 member from dk, and 3 minus 2 is, 2 is equals to 1. The value of dk is equals to 1. So this is all clear for this example. So our next example is, this is a frame structure, 2D frame, and all member are rigidly connected, all rigid joint member. So in this case we can calculate ds and dk both. So now we start the ds. Ds is equals to dac plus dsi, it means external static indeterminacy and internal static indeterminacy. So we can calculate first dac. DAC means external static indeterminacy. The formula is R minus C. So how many reaction are available? In this case, 3 support are available. Support A, support J, support I. 3 supports are available. 8A support, this is a fixed support. So 3 reaction are available. Vertical reaction, horizontal reaction and one moment. 8I, also the fixed support, so 3 reaction are available, vertical, horizontal and moment. At J, only 2 reaction are available because this is not a fixed support, this is the pin support. So only 2 reaction are available, horizontal and vertical. And total number of reaction, 3 into 3, 6 and 2, 8. The value of R is equals to 8, E. What is the E? E is the number of equilibrium equation are available. So this is the frame structure, 2D structure and rigid jointed. In this case, value of E is equals to 3. So calculate the DSC, put the all the values in formula and we can get the 8 minus 3 is equals to 5. Value of static, external static indeterminacy is 5. So also we can calculate DSI. For this case, DSI is equals to internal static indeterminacy. So put the formula 3c minus r dash. In this case, what is the c? C is the number of loops are available in our structure. So how many loops are available in this structure? We have 4 loops, 1, 2, 3 and 4. We have 4 loops in this case. And value of r dash, r dash is related to hinge, so one hinge at D available, at D. In this case, one hinge available at D. So value of C, because 4 loops are available, so value of C is equals to 4. R dash, the formula of R dash is equals to M dash minus 1. What is the M dash? M dash means how many member are connected by hinge. How many member are connected by hinge? At hinge, 2 member are connected, DC and D. At D, D is the hinge, 2 member are connected. First member is D and second member is DC. Then value of M dash is equals to 2 and minus 1. It means the value of R dash is equals to 1. Put the values of M dash, value of M dash is equals to 2 because 2 member are connected by hinge, and minus 1, that value of R dash is equals to 1. So put the value of C and R dash to DSI formula and we can get the DSI value. 11. It means total DAC is equals to external static indeterminacy and internal static indeterminacy. So the total is 16. It means we can say our structure is statically indeterminate. Our structure is statically indeterminate by 16 degree, because the value of DAC is equals to 16, so that we can say our structure is statically indeterminate by 16 degree. Also, decay is calculating. We can calculate the decay for this case. The formula is decay is 3J minus R plus R dash. Then J, what is the J? J is the how many joints are available in our structure. So first count the joints, joint A, B, C, D, joint A, joint B, joint C, joint D, and joint E, joint F, joint G, joint H, and joint I. Support is also a joint, and joint J, joint K, and joint L. So how many total number of joint? A, B, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 12 joint. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So how many joints are available? 12 joints are available in our structure. And how many reactions are available? 3 and 3, 6 and 2. 8 reactions are available. So value of R dash, R dash is related to hinge. So we can already calculate, we have already calculated the value of R dash is equals to 1. So value of R dash is equals to 1. Now put all the values in formulas and we can get the value of decay by 29. 3 into 12 minus 8, 8 is the number of reaction, 1 is the hinge, and 36, the value of decay is 29. So if neglecting the axial deformation, we can calculate the decay days. And what is the decay days? Decay days is the number of axially rigid member is subtracting from decay. So how many axially rigid member are available? So in this case, we have 15 member axially rigid connected by axially rigid jointed. So subtract from decay, the value of decay days is equals to 29 minus 15, the value of decay is equals to 14. This is the kinematic indeterminacy for after neglecting axial deformation. So this is it clear for all for this example? So thank you. That's all for today. In next lecture, we will discuss the pin jointed and about truss joint static and kinematic indeterminacy. Thank you.